Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm rendering exposition of Mark 6, 17-29. For Herod himself had sent forth and laid hold upon John and bound him in prison for Herodias' sake, his brother Philip's wife. Herodias was the wife of his brother Philip, but she was very clever, cunning, and beautiful, and she wooed Herod, and by wooing Herod she left his real brother Philip, and Herod married her, for he had married her. So Herod had married her because of her beauty, and she was too cunning to be true. For John had said unto Herod, it is not lawful for thee to have thy brother's wife. Now John the Baptist was a moral teacher. He was prophet Elijah, so the prophet of the moral laws. So he openly declared that Herod, what you are doing is wrong, and you are a sinner. Whereas the temple priest, they were psychic. So they wanted Herod was once born, and those psychic, they were clever, and they were just rendering praises to Herod, whether he was good or bad, as politicians render praises to their prime minister and other thing who is leading them, whether he is good or bad, as for example Bush and Blair. They created this war on Iraq, but when these politicians, they got together, they were just praising him for the sake of praising and not for the sake of truth or what is in their heart. So they were psychic hypocrites. Therefore Herodias had a quarrel against him and would have killed him, but she could not. So she was so revengeful against John the Baptist that if she had laid hand on John the Baptist, she could have killed him, but she could not. So she devised a plan how to kill him, using Herod, a once-born person, as a tool for his purpose. For Herod feared John. Herod himself feared John, because John was truthful and many people believed in John as a prophet, knowing that he was a just man and an holy. Holy means he was, everybody revered him and observed him. And when he heard him, he did many things and heard him gladly. Even Herod heard his teaching gladly. He was a moral teacher. So Herod even appreciated his wisdom. And when a convenient day was come, so this cunning woman, Herodias, was waiting for her chance how to entangle Herod into killing the John the Baptist. Convenient day was come that Herod on his birthday made a supper to his lords, high captains and chief estates of Galilee. So Herod had invited many honorable people of the area to celebrate his birthday. And so there were people whom he respected. And when the daughter of the said Herodias came in and danced and pleased Herod, and them that sat with him, the king said unto the damsel, ask of me whatsoever thou wilt, and I will give it thee. And he sware unto her, whatsoever thou shalt ask of me, I will give it thee unto the half of my kingdom. Now he was very generous, and he offered her, even her half the kingdom. She was so pleased with her dance. And when she found that he is very pleased with her dance, so she went to her mother, and she went forth and said unto her mother, "What shall I ask?" And she said, "The head of John the Baptist." Remember how revengeful she was. She was not after acquiring the half the kingdom, but she was so revengeful that this man, he is the one who is calling openly them the sinner. So he is the one who is speaking against her to everyone, telling that she is a sinner. So she wanted him to be killed at any cost. And she came in straightway with haste unto the king and asked, saying, I will that thou give me by and by in a charger the head of John the Baptist. So she asked, you know, as her mother told her what to ask, and she, the damsel, was in the clutches of her mother, so whatever her mother told her, she would do. And the king was exceedingly sorry. King was exceedingly sorry that he is a good man, and why she is asking for his head. Yet, for his oath's sake, and for their sake, which sat with him, he would not reject her. Because the once-born people who are clean-hearted, when they take oath, they take the oath seriously, and not like the twice-born people who are clever cheat of who flees, you know. They take oath for the sake of taking oath. But here, he took the oath to hold to his words. And for the sake of which was sitting beside him, so if he has gone back from his word, then all those sitting would tell him, "Hey, you just promised in front of us." They were witnesses. So for the sake of them, you know, he was very reluctant to accept what she was asking. And immediately the king sent an executioner and commanded his head to be brought, and he went and beheaded him in the prison, and brought his head in a charger and gave it to the damsel, and the damsel gave it to her mother. And when his laborers heard of it, they came and took up his corpse. The John the Baptist, he has disciples and not laborers. So they, when they heard of the death of John the Baptist, they came and took his corpse, dead body, and laid it in a tomb. So they buried him, you know, in a tomb, as the custom demanded. So here is a lesson. There were two people, character involved. One was the very cunning woman, which was the used to be the wife of Philip, because of her beauty and her cunning behavior. She wooed Herod, and because Herod was in a power position, so she married Herod, leaving his real brother, so causing a problem between the two brothers, and then marrying Herod. Now, what she did was not lawful. It was a transgression against the moral laws. So John the Baptist, being an ideal rabbi, so he openly declared that what she has done is wrong. John the Baptist was not a hireling, so he was not under the command of anybody. and thank you.